Today, I'm gonna show you a mathematical effect that will work through the screen, but you're gonna need four playing cards. Could be any four playing cards, but if you don't have four, stop what you're doing, press pause, grab your four playing cards, and we'll get started. Welcome to Impossible Science.
Have you ever wondered how to always find someone's card in a magic trick? Well, the secret is math.
Hey guys, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic. Today, we're gonna do a mathematical effect that is so unbelievable, you will literally fool yourself. Don't worry, by the end of this, you'll be able to do the effect and fool your friends and family through the screen of social media or whatever you choose to do. I've used this to fool millions of people around the world. You're gonna need four playing cards. They don't have to be the same playing card, but you will need four. So just pause the video and grab four playing cards. This is worth it, trust me. I'll wait. Okay, let's get going. Now, I'm gonna be using the four aces. You don't have to use the four aces, but I'm gonna use the four aces. I'm gonna go through a couple moves so that you can follow along. The first type of move I'll ask you to do on your side of the screen is to take the top card and move it directly to the bottom. The next move I could ask you to do is to take the top two cards together, flip them over together, and place them back on top. Now, it's important to note, as we get going, your cards may look different than mine. You might have face-up cards, you might have face-down cards, you might have them alternating one face-up and one face-down, but as long as you grab the top two cards together, flip them over together, and put them back on top, you'll be good. And lastly, you're gonna need to know how to cut the cards. That means you get to take as many cards as you want from the top, pick them up, and put them directly on the bottom of the pile. That's it. Now, what we need to do now is take your cards, put them face down, and mix them up. All right? Great. Now look at the bottom card. I'm gonna be using the Ace of Spades. Memorize what your bottom card is, okay? Once you have that, put the cards face down in your hand. Let's get started. Take the top card, place it directly onto the bottom. Take the next card, this top card, and turn it face up. Now I need you to cut the cards on your side of the screen. That means take as many cards you want from the top and put them directly onto the bottom. Now I want you to take the top two cards together, turn them over together, and place them back on top. And now you get to cut the cards as deep as you'd like. Now, again, I want you to take the top two cards together, turn them over together, and now cut the cards again as deep as you'd like. Now, we've had three cuts, and you've made choices. So your cards are completely different than the cards I have in my hand, which makes this effect even more unbelievable. But right now, the final steps, I want you to take the top card, I want you to turn it over and place it on the bottom. I want you to take this next top card, do not turn it over, and place it directly on the bottom. And this last card, this top card here, I want you to turn it over and place it back on top. Now, with all the choices we made, that makes a prediction seem pretty impossible. But if we spread out these cards right now, every single card will be facing one way except for one card. And that one playing card, if you pull it out, will be your card. Did I get it right? Now, the best part about this is you guys get some choices. Right now, you can go back and watch the video again, write down all the steps, and sit down and figure out the math of what's happening so that every time you do this effect, no matter what you do, you will still have one reverse card that is your card from the very beginning. And you'll understand the science, so therefore you can actually modify it to create a new effect. Or you can go back, write down the steps so that you can actually do the effect, but you don't even know why it works. The choice is yours. You can either forever see science or you can forever see magic. Just remember, the difference between magic and science is simply a difference in understanding. Because if you don't understand it, it will always look like magic. Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed making the impossible possible through science. And if you did, let me know by clicking the like button and subscribing to the channel. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.